The Financial Planner, presented by the Bombay Stock Exchange, IPF.
Welcome back. You're watching Financial Planner. I'm in conversation with Certified Financial Planner Sumit Ved. And if you'd like for us to take a look at your portfolio and tell you if your investments are working for you, you can always email us at financialplanner@utvmoney.com. All right, let's get started and climb up the investment ladder.
Investment Ladder, presented by the Bombay Stock Exchange, IPF.
I got an email from Sudhir, and it says, I'm a NRI, I live and work in Nigeria, I'm 56 years old. He says, I need a health insurance policy for when I retire and return to India. What policies and companies would you suggest, Sudhir? So the question is, of course, he lives in Nigeria right now. He's 56 years old. And Sumit, when you and I were discussing this, we were like, it doesn't matter where you live, you still need insurance, health insurance.
True. So it can be, in this case, you know, this gentleman already has an existing health insurance policy which has been provided to him by his employer and which will remain applicable till the time he works in Nigeria.
Sure.
So he is now planning that when he returns to India, his health insurance needs should be taken care of. I think it's a great idea to really think ahead and plan. So our advice to him will be, whenever on next trip he's in India, where, you know, he needs to just make sure he has a special time out to go and take this policy, because at his age, trying to figure out a right policy is not going to be pretty easy, because as you age up, the medical insurances become difficult and difficult to get.
Sure.
And that's why we keep advising our viewers that as quickly or as young you are, if you're able to take a health insurance and create a history within that company, I think it'll really help you as you move up. So in this case, our advice will be, when you come to India next, give yourself a window. At that point, you know, try and see which are the various term policies, which are the various health policies available to you, and try and take that part. It'll be very difficult for us to really give the terms right away, saying which are those products which you should really look forward to, because we don't know when he's returning. And these norms do change pretty quickly in the health insurance industry.
Right.
In fact, I want to highlight one more thing to this gentleman, that along with health insurance, he should also go in for a, you know, critical care policy, which is a critical illness, you know, policy, in which there are certain designated illnesses which are really heavy on the pocket. Let's say, for example, if cancer strikes someone, hospitalization will be a very later stage thing.
Right.
But there'll be a lot of medication involved, a lot of chemo involved, in which a lot of money will get spent.
Sure.
So many a time we don't think through and plan, on concepts like critical illness. But if you have a critical illness, as soon as that particular illness is detected and as per the policy, you'll get a certain amount of money given to you upfront in one lump sum, which can be used for taking care of pre-hospitalization and a post-hospitalization kind of an expenses. So it should be a combination of a medical insurance along with a critical illness insurance. And this critical illness insurance, I'm not advising as a rider to the life insurance.
Right.
Many a time, some of us really go in for a rider to life insurance. I'm saying go into a general insurance company along with the medical health insurance, take a separate critical illness policy. They are available to you.
Yeah.
Slightly costly, but makes a lot of sense, especially as you when you age up.
Right. And also, given our lifestyle that we lead these days, I think a lot of us are more prone to heart diseases and lifestyle related diseases, and which are detected only later on and also can tend to be rather expensive. I just want to look at another question, that if you are an NRI, do you have access to the same kind of health insurance policies? Does the insurance industry distinguish between an Indian and an NRI, or is there no difference at all?
Honestly, I'm not very sure about that, but I'm still giving you a context from my experience of saying, as an insurance industry, what I'm trying to say is that I'm issuing a policy to you which is applicable in Indian country. So till the time you are in this country, something happens to you, you are part of this. Till the time you're traveling outside country, or you are on a deputation or a working assignment, this is not applicable.
Right.
So the terms and conditions are designed to protect insurance companies' jurisdiction where it is applicable. To that extent, I think it will be possible for him to really go and take that insurance. And one thumb rule in insurance, always remember, always disclose full information.
Right, we've talked about this too, that don't hide anything from the companies.
Don't hide anything. Yeah. Even if it is going to get refused, don't hide it because it doesn't make sense. If you don't tell them right now you're NRI and you get a policy issued, at a later point when they come to know and they say this was not part of the norms and rules, you'll not get the desired money. So in life insurances, it's a contract, it's an agreement. Always tell the truthful information.
All right. On that note, let's slip into a break. Let's also tell you that we're taking email queries, or if you'd like to write it to us, just drop us a line. Tell us what you think about the show. You can do that at financialplanner@utvmoney.com.
The Financial Planner, presented by the Bombay Stock Exchange, IPF.